Hello friends, welcome to EC Academy. In this lecture, we'll understand the common base configuration of a transistor. A transistor can be connected in a circuit in three ways. First one is common base configuration, common collector configuration, and common emitter configuration. In common base configuration, base will be common between input and output. Common collector configuration, collector terminal will be common between input and output, and in common emitter configuration, emitter terminal will be common between input and output. So in this lecture, we'll understand the common base configuration. Now let us write the circuit for common base configuration. To write the circuit, let us consider a PNP transistor. Let us consider a PNP transistor. Now let us bias this transistor. So to bias the transistor, we need to know that the emitter base junction should be forward bias and the collector base junction should be reverse bias. Now let us make the connection. So we'll connect a resistor here across the emitter terminal RE. And since it is a P region at emitter terminal, we'll connect a positive, and N region is negative, positive and negative. Now let us connect a resistor across the collector, and collector base junction should be reverse bias, so we'll connect a negative to collector terminal and positive to base terminal, negative and positive. Let us call the voltage across emitter and base, we'll call that as VEE, and across the collector terminal and base terminal we'll call that as VCC. This is RC. The current flowing through the emitter terminal we'll call that as IE. The current flowing through base, we'll mark that as IB, and the current flowing through the collector, which is IC. Now the voltage between the emitter terminal and base terminal is VBE, and voltage between the collector terminal and base terminal is VCB. Now let us ground the base. So this is the circuit connection for common base configuration. In this circuit, we can understand that IE is the input current, VBE is the input voltage, IC is the output current, and VCB is the output voltage. So from the input side we'll give the weak signal, and at the output side we'll obtain the amplified signal. The output side is towards the collector and the input side is towards the emitter terminal. Now we can relate the input current and the output current by an equation. IC is equal to alpha DC into IE. So from this we can write alpha DC is equal to IC divided by IE. Here alpha DC is the current amplification factor, current amplification factor. So the ratio of output current divided by input current will give us the amount of amplification. So alpha DC is known as current amplification factor. Now let us understand the input characteristics of common base configuration. To understand the input characteristics of common base configuration, let us consider the input current, which is IE, input voltage, which is VBE, and output voltage, which is VCB, which will be kept as constant. And we will plot a graph of input voltage versus the input current. So if we consider only the input side of the common base configuration, we can see P side is connected to positive, N side is connected to negative terminal of the external voltage source. So this is similar to the forward characteristics of the PN junction diode. You can see P side is connected to positive, N side is connected to negative, which is similar to the forward characteristics of the diode. So as we keep on increasing VBE, IE will remain low up to the applied voltage reaches breakdown voltage. Once the applied voltage reaches the knee voltage or forward breakdown voltage, the current increases linearly. To plot this, we have kept VCB as constant. Let us say we have considered VCB as 5 volts. Now let us increase VCB. Let us increase VCB to 10 volts. Now let us do the same analysis. So as we keep on increasing VB, again the current will remain low and the current start increasing linearly. So as you can see, for VCB is equal to 10 volts, IE shifted towards left hand side, which means as we keep on increasing VCB, the current IE will also increase. Now let us understand the output characteristics of common base configuration. To understand the output characteristics, we will consider the output current, output voltage, and input current, which will be kept as constant. Input current is kept as constant. Now we know that the output current is IC, output voltage is VCB, and we are keeping input current, which is IE, as constant. So output current is IC, VCB is the output voltage, IE is the input current, which is kept as constant. Now let us plot the graph. In x-axis, we'll take VCB, and in y-axis, we'll consider IC. Now we need to keep the input voltage as constant. From this equation, we can write IC is equal to alpha DC IE. So here alpha DC will be approximately equal to 1. So it will not be exactly 1. So this value will be between 0.96 to 0.995. So we can say IC is approximately equal to IE, right? Now let us keep IE is equal to 0. Even for input voltage as 0, there will be a small current that will be flowing through the transistor. So this current is due to the reverse leakage current, ICBO. So even for IE is equal to 0, IC should have been 0, but it will not be 0. We will be getting a small current. That current is ICBO. So properly writing this equation, we should have written this as alpha DC IE into ICBO. We will neglect this current because this current is very, very small. So that's why we have not written in this equation. Now if we write that, and if we make IE is equal to 0, IC will be equal to ICBO. So this is the same current. Now for IE is equal to 10 milliamperes. So we will write IE in dotted line. So let us say IE is 10 milliamperes. The output current IC will be approximately equal, it will be similar to IE, but it will be lesser than IE. So we'll get a straight line. Now for IE is equal to 20 milliamperes. So we'll write that in dotted line. IC will be approximately equal and it will be a straight line. Now if VCB is made positive, initially we know VCB is negative voltage. Now if VCB is made positive voltage, the current decreases sharply like this. The current will decrease sharply. Now we can identify the region of operation. So this region where the current decreases sharply or VCB become positive, we can call that as the saturation region. The region where we are getting the graph, we can call that as active region. This region is active region, and the region where the transistor is not conducting, we can call that as cutoff region. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.